Thank you, Sarah. Well, thousands of volunteers are helping the Smith family deliver Christmas gifts to disadvantaged families. More than 20,000 hampers were given out, but there's more to be done.
Christmas is a time of giving, and at homes across the nation, hampers, toys and books were being handed out in carloads.
Look, there's great demand for our support. Sadly, there are lots and lots of families. One in seven children in Australia live in jobless families, and therefore the need is enormous.
Sue has four boys to fend for. The youngest, Armando, has a rare heart condition that left him in a four-month coma. As a sole parent, she's largely been out of work trying to look after her sons, and now has some Christmas cheer.
Football.
Just makes me feel a bit more relief that my kids have got a big smile on their face and got the things that they would love to have for Christmas.
This year, 3,000 more families have requested help to pay bills. That's up 10%.
The electricity, the gas, they don't stop and they keep going up. So, you know, times at Christmas is wonderful to have that time together and be all happy, but the pressure on families of trying to give the kids what they want is another pressure that we can't always deliver.
More than 100,000 toys will be handed out today, but there's still more that can be done. The Smith family was hoping to raise more than $4 million before Christmas, and with 2 weeks to go, they've only reached half the target.
I think what we see with retail sales is that when people are a little bit nervous, uncertain about their job security, interest rate rises, the danger is that they decide not to donate to charities at the same time as not spending money.
Those wanting to help can go to the Smith family's website. Adam Rascal, 10 News.